You're watching We Love DevOps, a video series on testing in DevOps brought to you by Team Miracle.
Hello everyone, I am Shubham Shukla and I am a QA lead at Miracle Software Systems. Topic today is continuous testing with AWS Code Build, Code Pipeline and Cycle. Let's look at the agenda. We are going to look at the key highlights of Cycle Test Automation tool, goal and objective of the session, Cycle integration with AWS CI/CD architecture, and a quick demo. And in the end, we will see what did we achieve. Key highlights of Cycle Test Automation tool. The tool is developed by Trion Solutions. It's a licensed tool. It has a built-in IDE for test case creation and execution. It is designed specifically to work with JDA WMS system. It can easily incorporate into your CI/CD workflow alongside solutions like Jenkins and Bamboo. It is designed with a non-technical user in mind, which means you don't need to have prior knowledge of the programming languages. It has multiple built-in features, including test report generation and sending out the test reports on the email. Cycle command line interface is a Windows binary. That means you cannot execute Cycle commands on a non-Windows machine. Goals and objectives. Goal for today is automate the process of test scripts execution after every successful build deployment. Evaluate build pass or fail status based on the auto-generated test report. Objectives are integrate Cycle with AWS CI/CD process to achieve continuous testing, sanity test each build to detect defects early, and reduce the overhead on the development and testing teams by continuous testing of multiple builds. Having said that, let's look at the architecture. First of all, as I stated previously, Cycle CLI commands need a Windows platform to execute. In this architecture, we see a box with the dotted lines. It is basically the Windows EC2 instance, and Cycle CLI commands are going to execute and run the test scripts inside this machine. Outside this machine, we have other services like Code Build and Code Deploy, which will be running on a Linux machine. Here, as you can see on the architecture on the left-hand side, DevLead is going to merge the code for the front-end or back-end application into the code commit repository, and QA Lead is going to merge the code of Cycle test scripts into the code commit repository. This code commit is a version control service by AWS, just like Git. Looking at the code build service, this code build service is going to fetch the latest code from the repository. It is going to build the code, and then the email will be sent out to the dev manager for approval. Once it is approved, with the help of code deploy service, we are going to deploy the code into the respective environment. Then we have a CloudWatch event rule configured in such a way that it is going to look at the success message, and it is going to trigger the Lambda function. The job of this Lambda function is to initiate the Windows EC2 instance. This Windows EC2 instance is an on-demand instance, which means it will run for the time only when it is required to run. Inside this Windows EC2 instance, we have a batch script configured. This batch script basically has a list of commands. Based on the commands, it is going to fetch the latest Cycle scripts from the repository. It is going to execute the test scripts with the help of CLI commands, and the output will be a testreport.html file. And we are going to drop this HTML file into a S3 bucket. Now, a couple of events will take place here. Once the file is dropped into an S3 bucket, Lambda function is configured in such a way that it will trigger automatically. It will pick up that file, and then with the help of SES service by AWS, which is simple email service, it is going to send out that file on an email to the end users in the form of attachment. Another event that is going to take place here is, once the file is dropped into an S3 bucket, there is a CloudWatch event rule configured, which is going to trigger the second Lambda function. And the job of this Lambda function will be to shut down this Windows EC2 instance. Now let's see a quick demo. Let's look at the AWS services that we have talked about in the architecture. First one is the code commit repository. So here, as we can see, there is a code commit repository for Cycle scripts, which is named at Cycle repo. Another one is for the sample application. Then we have a code pipeline configured. Let me kick off a new deployment right now. So as we can see, the deployment is now started and it is in progress. Once this deployment will be completed and successful, so as we discussed in the architecture, that there is a rule configured in such a way that it will trigger a Lambda function, which is going to initiate the Windows EC2 instance. So while the deployment is in progress right now, let's look at the rule first. So here is the rule, trigger Lambda initiate EC2 instance. Let's look at the code inside this rule. So basically, this rule is going to look at this code pipeline service with the name of deploy sample application. And once the deployment is successful, Here we can see that it is going to trigger a Lambda function with the name of initialize EC2 Lambda. Now let's look at this Lambda function. So here is the Lambda function, initialize EC2 Lambda. The job of this Lambda function is to initiate the EC2 instance. So let's look at the code. So as we can see, its only job is to start the EC2 instance, and we have provided a unique ID of the EC2 instance here. Now let's look at the EC2 instance. This is the Windows EC2 instance that we are talking about. It is named at cycle automation. As you can see, right now it is in stop state. So whenever the deployment will be completed in the background, it is going to start running automatically. Let me do a quick refresh. As you can see, this Windows EC2 instance is now in running state. This means that the cycle test scripts are getting executed inside this machine with the help of CLI commands that we have pre-configured inside the batch script. When the execution will complete, there will be a second rule which is configured in such a way that it will trigger the second Lambda function to stop the EC2 instance. Let's look at that Lambda function now. Here is that Lambda function with the name of stop underscore EC2 underscore Lambda. So if you look at the code inside this Lambda function, it is very simple. It is going to stop that same EC2 instance, and we have provided the unique ID of that EC2 instance here again. Now let's go back and see the status of EC2 instance to see if the execution is already completed or not. So as you can see, right now it is in running state, but now it has automatically come to stop state. Let me do a couple of refresh to make it finally to the stop state. Now the instance has completely stopped. And since the instance has stopped now, it means that the test report.html file should be available in the S3 bucket. Let's look at the S3 bucket now. So this is the S3 bucket where we are going to drop the test report.html file. The name of the bucket is cycle test report. Let me open this bucket. So as we can see, there is a HTML file dropped here. So that means in the background, there is another Lambda function configured, which is going to send out this test report to the end users in the form of attachment on an email with the help of SES service. Now, before opening and showing you all this test report, let me give you all a quick glimpse of the cycle tool user interface. This is the built-in IDE of the cycle tool. As we can see, this user interface is really attractive. On the top, we have a menu bar. And from the file, we can either import an existing project or we can start a new project. Then we have a top navigation where you can see there is a record action available, which means you can record and run your test scripts. On the left hand side, we can see there is an option to do a lot of settings within this tool. In the middle, we are going to write the test scripts. And on the right hand side, we will get a few suggestions by the cycle tool, like the requirements, parameters, and those kind of things. So as you can see, we have already a feature written down here with the name of user login Yahoo app. Inside the feature, we have a scenario written over here that we are going to launch a Chrome browser. We are going to navigate to the Yahoo application, and then we will try to log in into the application by providing the credentials. And then, as you can see, we have written cycle script over here. By looking at the script, we can see that this is written in a plain English language. We don't need to have any knowledge of the programming language to write these scripts. So we are going to open Chrome browser in a headless mode. Then we are going to navigate to yahoo.com. And then simply we are going to input username and password. And then we will click on the sign in button and try to log in into the application. So this is one feature or a test case that we are going to execute using the cycle test scripts. On the left hand side, let's look at a few settings quickly. Under the execution settings, we can see that there are settings to input delays. There are settings to put the wait times. So just with a click of button, we can easily download the web driver for the required browser. Then we have other settings available, like if you want to close your browser after every feature execution and several other settings. Then we also have an option to download the WinApp driver. Basically, this is used to inspect the element. The other settings includes report settings. Here we can decide what kind of test report we want to generate, for like a HTML report or a CSV report. And if we want to send out that report to the end users in an email as a form of attachment, that also can be configured here. Then we have a lot of other settings like capture settings, device settings, connections, credentials, etc. In the advanced settings, we can also configure Mocha connection, and then we will be able to execute Mocha commands as well. Now let's go back and look at the testreport.html document, which we have captured in the S3 bucket. Let me try to open this document. So here is the test report that is generated after the execution. So as you can see, we have each and every detail here, like how many features we have executed, how many passed, how many failed. Then we have the details of the scenario and each and every step, how much time it has taken to execute. And finally, a screenshot if at all there was an error during the execution. So everything is captured here in this report in the detail. So let's go back to our deck and see what did we achieve with this session. So we achieved 100% automation. There is no manual intervention required at any stage. We have achieved continuous testing in AWS environment. We have achieved time saving as there is no more manual monitoring of the build deployments. We have achieved cost optimization by auto turning on and shutting down the Windows EC2 instance. We have achieved zero wait time to kick off test case execution. We have achieved real-time test results through the automated process of parsing and sending the HTML report to the end users. And this is all done in a highly secure AWS environment in the VPC network, which is controlled by IAM rules and policies. That is all for today. Thank you.
Thank you for watching a video series brought to you by Team Miracle. For more videos on testing and DevOps, please visit miraclesoft.com/VLoveDevOps.